Hello everybody, welcome to Soul Design 72, where today we're gonna try to replicate this image of this farmer's daughter or farmer's wife, maybe, looking out of the window, dreaming away, about to milk the cows, perhaps. We'll never know. Auto scans empty or full. Well, let's not dwell on the details and go right to the painting or digital illustration, as we call it. I use the AMB Deja Vu brush. It's an imported brush, so it's not standard in the brush gallery. And let's do this, guys. I'm gonna take this color and make it a big size and just put it here, just like this, you see. And then here's a bit lighter color, and here we go to red, some kind of brown red. Here underneath it's much darker, as you can see, dark. Now this maybe a little bit smaller, so I can do this. Yep, and here we got the wood. This would be the wood. Just go straight down, hold the brush, and then you can see you can move it around and it straightens out. Just like that. Here we got a little more brighter color. And that's like this. I think we went a little too far, so we do take freeform and push it a little bit closer, like so. Then we have the floor, and on the floor there are hay. There is hay, bits of hay. Yeah, that's better to describe it. Okay, and here the bottom part, let's see. Yep, just drop it in like that, because we're gonna do something with it later. Here, there we go. Okay, and here we have more straight lines beneath, a little bit of gray stone, and there it's wood, I guess. Make it a little bit brighter, smaller. Out. Just like with the brush, you can also with the eraser, you can make straight lines like this. You see? Okay. I'm gonna take the rectangle. Right here, go to the Gaussian blur, and then blur it like that. Okay, now we're gonna take this color first and make it bigger. then wait, like so. We got the base color right here. Now we put on top these colors, the gray color. With the selection tool. Oh, and then freehand, of course. Okay, and then we do this. Drop it in. Up. Like so. And then repeat. Point, and go so. It usually doesn't take, but when I move it closer, it will take. That's a lousy bug. Now you see, it's a little bit bigger on my illustration. Just gonna take this and then put the freeform, put it up a little bit higher, like so. It's an easy way to see because this last, the shadow part is hitting your face, so that's easy way to decide where to put the face later on, I would think. Putting back the color and just move on. Let's see here. Oh, freeform, freehand, I mean, back to freehand. Point. Right. More. And here. I see I have done it again. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna put the rectangle here and then put it on freeform, go up a lot more. Alright. We can also use the rectangle to fill colors, like so. And there we go. Doesn't have to be exactly what's on the reference photo anyhow, but as close as possible, guys. Oop, point. It's so easy like that, don't you think? But it doesn't look that good. Not yet anyhow. Retouch it a little, and retouch it till it looks good. Retouch. I think you would rather listen to some beautiful music. So I will shut my mouth now, and I hope you enjoy the process of this illustration. And maybe comment. I love to hear from you, you guys. Really, I do. And talk to you later. Okay, bye bye.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alrighty, we're back. We're back on track. Here we go. Well, I think we're finished here. It was pretty difficult, I must say. There's a lot of details I have to consider. But look at it. Do you think it's good? Well, for now it's the best I can do. I hope you like the video. Put my name under it. That's text. There you go. Now let's choose. Round hand, just put in the S, so it'll be there. The size, adjusting. Well, I'm not happy with the milk cans.